Are the PUFAs in phosphatidylcholine supplements a concern?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Ben S. asks, are the PUFAs in soy or sunflower-based phosphatidylcholine supplements a concern? I don't think so. I mean, I think that you're looking at... I think you're looking at, you know, fairly low levels of PUFAs in there, but you know, the way that I see it is, yes, we want to restrict PUFA beyond what's needed, but what's needed is defined by what do we need to get our essential nutrients in. And so you're going to have to get your choline requirement from somewhere. And if you're getting it from the diet, it's coming largely from phosphatidylcholine. And so you should be able to meet your needs for phosphatidylcholine from the diet. It doesn't make any sense to me that we need to restrict PUFA so low that we can't get choline requirements met by phosphatidylcholine mainly. So that's the way that I view that. So I extend the same thing to like nuts. If nuts are an important part of your magnesium intake, eat the nuts that you need to get to meet that magnesium intake. But, you know, don't go overboard with nuts after that. But, you know, step one is get your micronutrients in. Step two is don't eat excess PUFA beyond what you need to do that. Thank you, Ben, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ Master Pass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the Master Pass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.